السلام عليكم ومرحبا وأهلا وسهلا بكم في درس جديد وقصة جديدة. Peace and hello and welcome to a new lesson and a new story. And today's story is really interesting because it also has a moral value, the story of the cicada and the ant. قصة الزيزي والنملة. قبل أن نبدأ, before we start, لا تنسوا الضغط على زر الإعجاب. Don't forget to press the like button والاشتراك في القناة and to subscribe to the channel. This video is brought to you by Learning Arabic with Angela.com. كانت النملة النشيطة مشغولة جدا في فصل الصيف. كانت تجمع حبوب القمح والشعير وتحملها إلى مخزنها، وكانت تخبئ هذا الطعام لفصل الشتاء القارس. أما الزيزو فكان يقضي يومه في الغناء وعزف الموسيقى، وكان ينام لساعات طويلة ويضحك من أمر النملة ويقول: لماذا تقضين وقتك في العمل؟ لم لا تمرحين وتلهين مثلي؟ وكانت النملة تحذره وتجيبه قائلة: لا تؤجل عمل اليوم إلى الغد. وعندما انتهى فصل الصيف وجاء فصل الشتاء، لم يجد الزيزو ما يأكله وكان جائعا جدا. أما النملة فكان لديها ما يكفي من الطعام. توسل إليها الزيزو لتطعمه فأشفقت عليه وفعلت، وشعر بالندم على ما فعله ووعدها بأن يكون مجتهدا وأن يسمع النصيحة. The moral of the story: لا تؤجل عمل اليوم إلى الغد. من يزرع يحصد. Gonna go back to explain a few things to you. Quickly going back to the first slide. And there's gonna be multiple choice questions at the end, so stick around till the very end. There's gonna be quite a few questions for you to answer and to practice your comprehension and grammar skills as usual. So, كانت النملة النشيطة. نشيطة. From nashit, which is an adjective that means hardworking and enthusiastic about something. And a synonym is mujtahid. So if we say tilmidun nashit, that means a hardworking and literally an energetic student. He's also an enthusiastic about what he does. أو عامل نشيط, a hardworking and enthusiastic worker. أو عامل مجتهد. And we have the noun as well, nashat, which means energy or activity. So for example, if we say nashat dirasi, that means a scholar activity or a studying activity that you might do in class. Al-anshita dirasiya in the plural, so the plural would be anshita or nashatat. And that would be the opposite of Nashit would be the opposite of kasul, which is lazy, kasul. And we have the noun kasal, which is laziness, kasal. Mashghul means busy, mashghul. So you can say, ana mashghulun al-yawm, that means I'm busy today, or ana mashghulatun al-yawm in the feminine, I'm busy. And we can also say, for example, if you called someone, الهاتف مشغول, the line is busy, the phone is busy, الهاتف مشغول. So useful adjectives and nouns to know. كانت, هي كانت, referring to النملة, the ant, كانت تجمع. So from verb جمع, يجمع, to collect or gather something. And in Arabic, when we say الجمع, that means literally the plural of something, or it could mean addition as well. So جمع, the verb, is to collect or gather something. So حبوب is grains. حبوب, and it, you could also refer to حبوب as in, for example, pills or tablets that you take, حبوب الدواء, medication tablets, or you could even zits that one gets on the face, حبوب as well. So you have different meanings. حبة is the singular term. حبة. حبة is a singular term. قمح is wheat. شعير is barley. تحملها, she carries it, referring to حبوب القمح. So literally carrying the wheat and barley grains. حبوب القمح والشعير. Of course, we use تحملها and not تحملهم, because in Arabic, plural non-human, we refer to using singular feminine pronouns. So تحملها, literally carrying her or it. So we use the ها. We don't use هم. We don't say تحملهم. تحملها. If you think about books, for example, كانت تجمع الكتب, for example, she was collecting books. وتحملها, not تحملهم. We always, for non-human plurals, the nouns, we use a singular feminine when we're referring to them. For example, beautiful books. كتب جميلة. So we use the singular feminine adjective, جميلة, for كتب in the plural. إلى مخزنها, to her storage, the ant's storage. مخزن is a storage, مخزن. That's a useful noun to know. So جمع, يجمع. حمل, يحمل, to carry. And حامل, which is the active participle, someone who's carrying something, and it could also refer to a pregnant woman, and we say امرأة حامل, a pregnant woman. Not حاملة, just pay attention, it stays like that. امرأة حامل, a pregnant woman. Literally, she is carrying. وكانت تخبئ هذا الطعام, and she used to hide this food, لي, for, firstly, season of winter, الشتاء القارس. فصل is a season, الشتاء winter, قارس means شديد البرودة أو بارد جدا. So it's a synonym for very cold. تخبئ from verb خبأ, يخبئ, to hide something. قارس, very cold. In English, you would say bitter cold, to the extent that it's a bit painful. قارس. أما الزيز فكان يقضي يومه في الغناء وعزف الموسيقى. أما, as for, the cicada, Aziz, كان يقضي, he used to spend his day, كان يقضي يومه, his day, في الغناء, in singing, وعزف الموسيقى, and playing music. يقضي, from verb قضى, يقضي, literally to spend his time within this context. قضى وقته, he spent his time. We can ask someone, كيف قضيت العطلة? How did you spend the holiday? أو كيف قضيت وقتك في العطلة? Addressing a female, كيف قضيت وقتك في العطلة? And we use the preposition في. So يقضي وقته في. He spends his time in, literally. غنى means singing. عزف is playing. عزف الموسيقى playing music. From verb عزف يعزف. عازف is someone who plays music, for example, in a band. عازف. وكان ينام لساعات طويلة ويضحك من أمر النملة ويقول وكان ينام and he used to sleep لي for ساعات hours and it's the plural of ساعة an hour طويلة long remember this is non-human plural ساعات so the adjective gonna be feminine singular طويلة just as كتب جميلة beautiful books we're not gonna use the plural although كتب is plural but because it's non-human plural the adjective will be singular feminine just as the case over here لساعات طويلة ويضحك من أمر النملة that means he laughs at her matter at what's going on or what's up with her ويقول and he says يضحك from verb ضحك يضحك to laugh and this is a funny thing over here which is the equivalent of what you would write in English like that or the laugh out loud basically you just type the ha or in your keyboard and you just keep pressing it and you get that our Arabic LOL laugh out loud لماذا تقضين وقتك في العمل why do you spend your time وقتك working remember we use the preposition في literally why do you spend your time in work or in working however in English you don't use that preposition but in Arabic we have to use في لما لا is why not so if somebody for example asks you to go out for lunch you can say لما لا why not لما لا تمرحين وتلهين مثلي why don't you have fun and play just like me مثلي like me تمرحين from verb مرح يمرح and the gerund مرح which means to have fun to do as one pleases and to play تلهين from verb لها يلهو and the gerund له so لها has an additional meaning you're having fun but at the same time it's distracting you from doing something else for example if you're playing computer games but you should be studying that's what we call له So you're having fun, but you're distracted from something that is probably important. وكانت النملة تحذره وتجيبه قائلة لا تؤجل عمل اليوم إلى الغد. So تحذر from verb حذر يحذر. وتؤجل from verb أجل يؤجل. And أجاب يجيب. We said here تجيبه. So if you look at these three verbs, what is common is I've put it in red for you is that the present tense prefix starts with a dhamma. Because as I've mentioned earlier, the verb is actually based on four letters. So حذر because it's doubled over here. So that's four letters. وأجل four letters. وأجاب one, two, three, four letters. حذر to warn something. تحذير is a warning. And that's a warning sign. أجل to postpone or to delay something. أجل يؤجل. تأجيل is the gerund or the noun. أجاب يجيب to respond or to reply. إجابة is an answer or a reply to something, to a question, for example. So كانت تحذره وتجيبه she used to warn him and to reply back or to respond قائلة saying so قال يقول قائل is the active participle لا تؤجل don't delay or don't postpone عمل اليوم today's work إلى الغد to tomorrow literally and that's actually a famous saying in Arabic وعندما انتهى فصل الصيف and when summer season ended وجاء فصل الشتاء and spring season literally came or arrived جاء like verb أتى or وصل to arrive So these are synonyms as well. And انتهى, that means to end, and انتهى ينتهي, انتهى ينتهي, and the gerund is انتهاء, ending or end. بدأ, يبدأ, to start. So we can say وعندما انتهى فصل الصيف وبدأ فصل الشتاء. So instead of saying جاء, we can say and when winter season started. So بدأ, يبدأ, verb to start. بدء is the gerund أو بداية, which means a start or a beginning. لم يجد الزيز ما يأكله. So the cicada didn't find anything to eat. لم يجد, he didn't find. So يجد from verb وجد, يجد, to find something. وجود means existence, literally. And when we speak of God, الله الواجد, we describe him as الواجد, literally the finder and founder of everything. So he finds or brings to about to existence everything. الواجد. And وجود is existence. So he didn't find anything to eat. So ما over here is not ما, that negates the verb. So you have also different kinds of ما in Arabic, different kinds of ما actually. And over here, it's literally a relative pronoun. So he didn't find that which he could eat or that which he could eat in that sense. So it literally means that, like a relative pronoun in English. لم يجد الزيز ما يأكله. That means what he could eat. وكان جائعا جدا. And he was really hungry. So جائع أو جوعان is the same, and both are active participles from the verb جاع, to feel hungry or to be hungry. In the feminine, جائعة أو جوعانة. There are more than one ways to derive the feminine, but I'm just giving you the easy, straightforward ones. And that's the opposite of شبعان and شبعانة in the feminine, which means full, from verb شبعة, to feel full. أما النملة فكان لديها ما يكفي من الطعام. أما as for the ant, she had, كان لديها. لديها, she has. كان لديها, she had. So كان sets the sentence to the past. ما يكفي. So ما over here is not the ما of negation. It means that which is enough. ما يكفي. من الطعام, of food, literally. يكفي from verb كفى يكفي, to be sufficient or enough. And in Arabic, if you tell someone كفى أو يكفي, that means enough or stop. Stop doing what you're doing. So كفى أو يكفي. And in the Quran, you have كفى بالله وكيلا, which means God is the sufficient protector. أو كفى بالله حسيبا, God is the sufficient reckoner, literally. توسل إليها الزيز لتطعمه. So توسل, يتوسل, to plea or plead or beg. So you're literally asking in a pleading tone. Like, please, please give me some food. توسل إليها. He pleaded to her, إليها. لتطعمه. So that she can feed him. From verb أطعم, يطعم, to feed. And we know طعام is food. أطعم, to feed. فأشفقت عليه. From verb أشفق, يشفق. She felt pity for him, or she pitied him. أشفقت عليه. Literally at him. أشفقت عليه. وفعلت. And she did. So she gave him food. فعلت. وشعر بالندم. شعر is to feel. شعر بالسعادة, he felt happiness, or he felt happy. شعر بالحب, he felt love. شعر بالحزن, he felt sadness, or that literally means he felt sad. We often use the preposition be, so that's very important to know. أنا أشعر بالحزن, I feel sad or sadness, literally. So ندم means regret, ندم. And the verb is ندم, يندم, to regret something. And when we say أنا نادم, that means I'm regretful أو أنا ندمان, both in the masculine. أنا نادمة in the feminine, I'm regretful. And then you can say آسف أو آسفة, I'm sorry. Again, ما over here is not the ma of negation. He felt regretful about that which he did, literally. So I'm giving you the literal translation so you can understand what it means. ما فعله, what he did. ووعدها بأن, and he promised her that. From verb وعد, يعد, to promise. وعد is a promise, وعد. بأن يكون مجتهدا, that he will be hardworking, وأن يسمع النصيحة, and to listen to advice. نصيحة is advice. What we can take away from the story, لا تؤجل عمل اليوم إلى الغد. In English, you would say, never put off till tomorrow what you can do today. Literal translation, don't delay today's work until tomorrow. And another one of my favorites, من يزرع يحصد. So he who plants literally or sows will reap or will harvest. من يزرع يحصد. In English, you would say, you reap what you sow. هذه كانت نهاية القصة. That was the ending of the story. But we have the questions. أجب على الأسئلة التالية. Answer the following questions. First, choose the right answer. اختر الإجابة الصحيحة. So ألف باء أو تاء. A, B or C. If you don't have an Arabic keyboard or it's a hassle, please just write one. A or B or C and so on. And drop your answers in the comments box. كانت النملة, what adjective should go here? مشغولة جدا في فصل الصيف. النشيط, النشيطة, النشاط. Be mindful, is it an adjective or a noun in this case? مضاد النشاط, مضاد النشاط. What's the opposite? الضد, يعني the opposite. الاجتهاد, الكسول أو الكسل. مرادف نشيط, the synonym of نشيط. مجتهد, كسول أو اجتهاد. Pause the screen if I'm going too fast and think about your answers and write them down. ماذا كانت تفعل النملة في فصل الصيف? What was the ant doing in summer season, في فصل الصيف. كان يجمع الحبوب, كانت تأكل الحبوب, كانت تجمع الحبوب. Think about the prefixes, which ones go for here and هو and the relevant pronoun. مرادف قارس, حار, بارد أو نشيط. وكانت النملة, what was she doing with the food? الطعام لفصل الشتاء القارس. What was she doing with the food regarding the winter season? تخبئ, خبأت, تنقل. Again, think about what tense you're going to use. صل بين الكلمة والصورة. Match the word to the picture. الغناء. Again, you can write one, A, two, B, and so on. عزف الموسيقى, العمل, والمرح. الغناء, عزف الموسيقى, العمل, والمرح. ماذا كانت تقول النملة للزيز? What was it that she used to tell him? لا تؤجل عمل الغد إلى اليوم. أجل عمل اليوم إلى الغد. لا تؤجل عمل اليوم إلى الغد. One of them is the right one. الزيز كان يقضي يومه على, في أو إلى الغناء وعزف الموسيقى. Which preposition is the correct one? الزيز كان ينام لساعات. We spoke about this, I think at least twice in the video. طويل, طويلة أو طويلة. Think about your sounds as well. وعندما, we have to use verbs over here, فصل الصيف و verb فصل الشتاء. And when summer season ended and winter season came, انتهى جاء نهى بدأ ينتهي جاء. So one of these choices is correct. مضاد جائع. مضاد جائع. The opposite of جائع, رائع, مجتهد أو شبعان. ما رأيكم؟ وجد. What do you mean by وجد? He lost, he found, or he searched. Think of when I told you الله الواجد. الواجد. What does that mean? صل بين الكلمة ومعناها. Match the word to its meaning. أطعم, أشفق, توسل, وندم. And over here you have to beg, to regret, to feed, and to pity or feel pity for something or someone. وشعر زيزو بي. What did he feel? النشاط, الندم, أو التعب على ما فعله, regarding what he's done, what he did. لا, complete the sentence over here. عمل اليوم إلى الغد. What would you say? لا, عمل اليوم إلى الغد. Complete the proverb. من, something, يحصد. Complete the proverb over here. النهاية, the ending. Don't forget to post your answers in the comments and any questions that you may have, and I'd be more than happy to help you. And inshallah, see you in the next video. في أمان الله ورعايته وحفظه. Sending you all my thanks and my love.